G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, a little bit of a break from tradition, I'm not going to do any SketchUp. Instead, I'm going to show you how to use Google Sheets to set up an estimating page. And eventually we'll get through and put some formulas in it and combine multiple sheets into a summary page. But just for the first video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up the columns and the rows, and then we'll get into the calculations a little bit later on. So what I've done here is I've opened up a Google Sheet, and up the top here, you can call it what you whatever you'd like to call it. I'll call this one Buildsum Estimate. So that's named, and because this is a Google Sheet, it'll be automatically saved. But if you're using Excel, you'll have to save that separately by hitting the little save button. A lot of the functions, even though I am using Google Sheets, will translate into Excel. Definitely the functionality, what it will do is the same. There may be just a different button or a different symbol or just a slightly different way of actually going about it in Excel. So if you don't have Google Sheets, which you should because it's free, if you want to use Excel, you can. Things will be fairly similar. Okay, so for our estimating sheet, I'll need six columns. However, one column, which is going to be my particulars column, I actually want to make that up out of nine cells. I want nine cells in that column. So I'll just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. So all I'm doing there is I'm clicking on and holding the mouse down, and I'm selecting the columns that I want. 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so once I've selected the columns I want, this little symbol here will merge those cells together. Okay, so they all become one cell. Okay, now I don't need them all to be the same size, so you can just hover over the break in the columns and you can close them up, and you'll see why a little bit later on while I'm closing these up like I am, and we'll be able to move them in and out as we need to. Okay, and then pretty much the rest of the columns are just what they are. So this column here, I'm going to call that the item column. Okay, so that's just how we number the items so we can identify them. This column here is going to have all our information. So this is going to be the particulars column. So I'm just selecting on the column and typing. And if you want, you can select one or multiple of those. And this little button here, a horizontal line, will let you move that into the middle of the column. And you can do that with all of these. This column over here will be the unit, what unit of measure we're going to measure, calculate in. This will be the quantity. And then we have the rate, or the actual price. And then we're going to have a total. Okay, so that's the actual units or the headings that we want. We can select all of those and put them all into the middle in one hit. And we can also select all of those. Select them all. And if you hit the bold symbol, we can bold them up because they stand out as headings. And then also because they're a heading, I might just put a border around them for now. So you can go to borders. We want a box around everything that we've selected. So we'll go for this option. And we want it to be a fairly thick line. So go into here and I'll pick the thickest line. So then we have our little particulars box. Okay, so that gives us our heading, and we can select just by clicking and holding as many of these as we need. And we can then put a line around them. Again, hit the borders, select the pattern. So I want all the lines selected. And I don't want the thick ones for this, so I just go back over here and hit the thinner line. That gives us some thinner lines for our box. Okay, and because we had that top one selected, it picked that again. So I'm going to just go back into here, select that. Because I only want the outside border, I can go to this option and select the thicker line again, and it'll come back like that. Okay, so that's basically setting up the actual table. In the next video, I'll go into the process of starting to fill it out and some basic calculations. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.